Hey guys, how's it going? I got Tweak here. Once again, I mean, we talked about Diddy last time and then you said you'd be willing to come back and talk about Sephiroth. So that's what we're gonna do. I guess to start things off, how do you think Sephiroth varies from online to offline? Because I think the last time we talked to you said that you feel like Sephiroth struggles a lot more than people think online. Is that still your opinion after playing more offline or?
The reason I had such a hard time using Sephiroth online basically comes down to I couldn't get the easy stocks with like F-tilt ledge trapping, even like a simple back air. I always had to fall back on the quickest frame data possible, like neutral airs, down tilts, you know, simple grabs while ledge trapping rather than going for kills. So in a way, it's like makes the character a lot harder. Characters just naturally live longer, but it also forced me to get really, really creative with the character. And in a way, it helped me like work harder to really figure him out and learn him. So whenever I'd play offline, it was kind of like taking off the training weights, and it's like I can do all the stuff I was doing online, but I can also just get the occasional like simple stock just because there's less input delay. Playing Sephiroth offline always reminds me that like he's not just good, like he's really good. And sometimes when you play online, you kind of forget when you play Sephiroth, just because like I said, sometimes you don't just get the simple early stock or like simple early kill with like an F tilt or whatever. So yeah, playing him offline is like a breath of fresh air, to say the least.
Okay, yeah, so I mean, I guess what it sounds like you're saying is online you have to pick way less committal or non-committal options, but those non-committal options don't really benefit Sephiroth that well. Like you probably have to do like way more interactions to actually close a stock. And then I guess that also sucks because for a character like Sephiroth, he's so light and stuff that if he's like letting his opponent live longer, they're just getting more rages, easier for them to kill him.
Yeah, so it kind of led to me like also leaning towards a more defensive style online. Like I would just camp super hard. I'd use a lot of empty movement and do a lot of like movement tricks that didn't really lead to anything, but it just helped me like keep a lead and like continue to stay ambiguous, which also kind of helped in a way when I went to offline, because I feel like my Sephiroth is like very disciplined now. And I don't take anything for granted or take too many risks. So it feels like, you know, in a way, playing online really helped me with discipline and consistency. And I guess that's what I have to be thankful for. For example, like playing online, like in a situation where I'd go for an F tilt, I'd go for like a grab or a down tilt, and it would kind of just like reset and they would just grab the ledge again. Or I'd have to really work hard to like take their stock afterwards because there's like no true follow-ups.
Okay, so the last time we talked, you also said that you think Sephiroth is top tier. I would assume that opinion has not changed.
It's not changed. I think if anything, he might be slightly lower in top tier than what I thought. I don't know if this is biased because I'm not playing him in tournaments as much as I play like Diddy Kong, but I still think he's top tier. I think he might be a spot or two lower. We'll see what happens. It kind of worries me that I'm like already like I haven't even used him and I'm already like feeling like he would go down on my tier list if I made one, but maybe not. I definitely need to see information from other players. I definitely should probably play him once in a while myself, but yeah, he's definitely still like one of the best characters in the game, and I don't think anything could change my mind on that.
Okay, why haven't you been playing him? Because like you said, you have been playing just Diddy Kong at Momentous, the only offline tournament you've been to so far. I recall correctly, you went all Diddy Kong.
If I can play Diddy Kong, I will. And it's as simple as that. If I feel like I can't use Diddy Kong, then that's where Sephiroth and Wolf come in, which obviously is rare because I went an entire bracket without switching. But they are a pretty like nasty like backup plan. So basically, it all comes down to I think Diddy Kong is my best character by like a ridiculous margin. Even like, you know, like past characters at their peak and stuff, I think even if you combined all of them, it wouldn't even be what my Diddy Kong is. I guess it's just confidence in my Diddy Kong, and I just personally think he's my best character ever. I've put a lot of time into him. I didn't realize this, but someone told me this. I've been playing Diddy Kong longer than I played any other character. It's just, it was during quarantine. I just realized that I've been playing Diddy Kong longer than I was playing Wario. So I guess all that like practice and time into the character is definitely like coming to fruition.
Yeah, you know what's crazy? And I don't think a lot of people realize this. Quarantine has lasted longer than Smash Ultimate's offline life.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I connected those pieces, but then I didn't realize that also applies to the character I was playing. And I was like, wow, I've been playing Diddy Kong for a long time now.
Yeah, it's insane. Like, legit. It's kind of frustrating when you think about it, because half of Ultimate's life has been online, and the netcode is awful. Like,
it's not playable at all.
Yeah, so like the meta just looks so messed up because there's so many things that we're probably just not going to know or realize until offline comes back.
Yeah, all the patches and stuff, like, and using that for data is pretty inaccurate because it hasn't been through offline tournaments. So yeah, the meta is completely different, and there's a lot of characters that can like blatantly abuse online, and we've seen that a lot, and it's really hard to deal with. And some characters I just think technically can't. So it's definitely like a gamble to pick them in like an online tournament or something. But yeah, going back to quarantine in general being so long, and the online portion of Ultimate being so long too, I'm kind of thankful for it, kind of going back to like my Sephiroth practice, because before, you know, quarantine, there was like a tournament every week or every other week or something. Yeah. So I don't know if I ever would have actually taken the time to take Diddy Kong as serious as I did. So I feel like I wouldn't be maining Diddy Kong. I've always played Diddy Kong for fun just because I like Diddy Kong, but I wouldn't have sat down and practiced a bunch of tech and really taken him serious as you know, the core of my gameplay. But since, you know, I had so much time to myself over quarantine, I was able to sit down and actually put many months into him until I felt like truly comfortable. So honestly, I'm really thankful for it, because I don't know if that would have happened without quarantine.
Yeah, that, I feel the same, not just about you, but like for some other characters, or for some other players. Like, I guess for me personally, I definitely would not be playing Falco as much as I have if it was for quarantine. I don't think Leo would be playing Byleth as much, because like he's been playing mainly Byleth since quarantine. I mean, those are like the players that come to mind, but there's definitely more.
I'm sure a bunch of people have this experience, and honestly, like Diddy Kong is definitely the most fun I've had with the game, so I'm like very grateful for that. He's also just super technical, and he can do so much crazy stuff, and he just feels like a great character. So I'm definitely excited to compete again, especially after having so much time away from like competing every 5 seconds.
Yeah, you talked about how Diddy Kong is personally your best character, and that, you know, if push comes to shove, you'll go Sephiroth or Wolf. So just, I guess, putting more focus on Sephiroth, do you think Sephiroth is a better character than Diddy Kong?
Yeah, I think kind of going back to Diddy Kong's like matchups and stuff, that's the hardest thing when it comes to placing him on a tier list. And despite him being my strongest character, or at least that's how I feel, right now he can't really do it all for me because certain matchups are just that hard. So that's where characters like Sephiroth and Wolf come in. And I think because of that, those characters are both better than Diddy Kong on a tier list, because they might not body some top tiers as hard as Diddy does, but they aren't losing to other characters. So I guess I value that consistency more. Obviously, Diddy Kong's peaks are like amazing, and it definitely brings him higher on the tier list regardless of having some terrible matchups, or at least that's how I would view it. Diddy Kong is still like a top 20 like type of character, in my opinion. But I would put Sephiroth and Wolf much higher just because you can pick them in like more universally.
Okay, so they're just, you think they're more consistent than Diddy Kong is, like across the board? Okay.
I think Diddy Kong has potential to like combat like his flaws and be a consistent character, but it requires doing a lot of crazy stuff, I think.
Yeah, I mean,
I still have hope for all the bad matchups. Like, my mindset is like, if outside of a tournament environment, I'd like to practice against Pac-Man and Duck Hunt, and maybe I'll figure something out. But if you sat me down in a tournament setting against like Diddy Kong's like worst of the worst matchups, I would go like Sephiroth and Wolf.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, that totally makes sense. You don't want to play bad matchups as a competitor. Well, it's just horrible.
There's some of them that I've practiced enough, and I feel like Diddy, like, regardless of me like having options to play a winning matchup, I'll still play the losing matchup if it's not as bad as like Pac-Man or Duck Hunt. Those are usually the comparisons for like the worst. Like against Olimar at Momentous, that matchup is, you know, definitely usually not considered in Diddy's favor, but like it's one of those matchups where I'll do it anyway. Kind of going back to what I said about if I can use Diddy Kong, I will. It's not the worst thing ever. It's just kind of like slightly losing in my opinion. So I'll just like go through it just because I think Diddy is my strongest character.
Okay, so going through your Momentous run, you kind of just, I mean, you won pretty solidly. Is there anyone that you felt like gave you like considerably more trouble than anyone else? And if so, why?
Going like back to like pools of Momentous, I think my hardest match potentially of the whole tournament was John Numbers. I think it's one of those matchups that fit under the category of something Diddy Kong might find frustrating. Projectiles, deep breathing. And I also actually have a lot of personal troubles with Wii Fit historically. Almost every time I've played against a Wii Fit in tournament, I've lost a game. I don't think I've ever dropped a set to Wii Fit, but for example, some people might not know this, in round one pools of Evo, I lost game one to a Wii Fit pretty solidly.
I did not know that. Wow.
Yeah, I don't remember their tag. They were really good. And for the next two games, I just kind of did what I always did with PT, where I just played like 90% Squirtle. And I was just like, screw this. I am using Squirtle until this is over. Like, just like using my fast frame data and just trying to make sure they don't kill me. Basically, every time I played against Wii Fit, it's been terrifying. So yeah, against John Numbers, it was a combination of me like just not really understanding Wii Fit or like having a hard time, and also I think Diddy Kong having an awkward time too. So honestly, going into the event, especially since I knew who was in my pool, that's what I was worried about the most, and it's what ended up being the most difficult match as well. That match definitely had me nervous.
Okay, wow. Yeah, I didn't know you had that much trouble against Wii Fit. That's crazy. So from what I'm noticing, you're talking about like Wii Fit Trainer, Pac-Man, Duck Hunt, you know, zoners. My question to you is, do you feel like you personally struggle against zoners? Or do you think it's just Diddy Kong? Or I mean, do you think it's like a combination of the two?
I want to say like with confidence that it's like definitely Diddy Kong, especially considering I feel like after some practice and like with the character, and even in some of these specific matchups, I'm really willing to do a lot of them, just not all of them at the moment. Like for example, Olimar is perfectly fine. Yeah. I would probably go Diddy Kong versus Young Link, Samus. Like those are a few matchups that a lot of Diddy Kong players probably wouldn't even consider. So I think I personally have a good grip on fighting zoners, but Diddy Kong definitely makes it an uphill battle. But I'm willing to put the effort in to figure it out just because I'm so confident in my Diddy Kong, and he's also just my favorite character to use. But some of them I just still haven't been able to figure out. Who knows if I'll ever figure them out. I have small hopes for some of them. The only one I think is not worth it at all is Pac-Man, just because I don't see anything to exploit with Diddy Kong at least. Yeah, I definitely would say it's definitely all on Diddy, especially considering there are a bunch that I'm willing to do anyways.
Yeah, okay, yeah. I mean, makes sense. You're definitely, like, with the Wii Fit thing, I'm still thinking about that because I legit did not know. Like, holy Jesus.
I feel like the only person who knows is actually B, because she's, like, watched many of my sets. So it's kind of like an inside joke at the moment that if I have to play against a Wii Fit, like, we're sweating, like, collectively.
Yeah.
Just because it's just, I don't know, I have a hard time every time.
I guess just talking more about Momentous, is there any player that really surprised you that you play or didn't play? I actually don't know. Were you able to play, like, friendlies against other people? I'm assuming you did.
I played Leon for the first time offline, actually, at that tournament. Even though we're from Jersey, I never played Leon offline.
Really?
Yeah. But yeah, Leon did amazing, of course. Leon got second. It's actually crazy how well he does versus the Buzz. I don't know if you feel this way. You probably do. I feel like Leon would be the type of player and character that would not have so many wins on the Buzz, just knowing how the Buzz is with like his consistency and how like certain characters usually just don't get the job done versus him.
Yeah.
But I feel like Leon is just that good. It blows my mind. I'm like, how is this happening again? Like,
yeah.
The Buzz did great at the tournament.
Yeah.
He's still like as consistent as ever, but I just don't know. It's how does Leon do it?
You know what I think it is? Because I feel like, you know, DeBuzz is a very calculated player, and Leon, like, sometimes he does some random stuff. Like, it's like, why would you do that?
The whole time when I watch Leon, I'm just like, I've just never seen him, like, give a fuck ever.
Yeah.
When has he ever cared? Which is perfect. Like, I feel like that's how Bowser would play. Like,
yeah.
If Bowser was a human being playing as himself in Smash, that's how he would want it to go. I respect it, and, like, for the heaviest character in the game, maybe that's the type of person that needs to play him. Someone that just doesn't care ever. Even in winner's finals, loser's finals, whatever it is. I don't know.
He's just the human embodiment of Bowser, man.
He is. He's just 100%. That's why, like, playing against him for the first time, it's like, who knows what you're signing up for. Is even though we're both from Jersey, like, I haven't played against him myself, I can definitely say, even playing him, he doesn't care. He doesn't care ever. No one has ever made him care. Like, if I ever see a player make Leon care at all, then I'm like, I'm gonna go up to Leon and be like, yo, like, are you okay? Like, do we need to talk? Damn. It's impressive how he's so willing to take crazy risks, and like it really works out with Bowser because you're the heaviest character in the game.
Yeah. Going more into your matches with Leon, you played him twice. First set was kind of just like, felt like it was like an easy win for you, and then the grand final set seemed more difficult. I don't know if you feel the same way. Do you feel like the grand final set was harder? And if so, why do you think that is?
I think throughout the tournament, I actually talked about this with B afterwards, like when we got home and stuff. She was saying she was pretty surprised at how risky and how crazy I was getting sometimes. I felt like I was definitely like feeling myself a bit too hard occasionally. Maybe it was like first tournament back and I was having a little too much fun with it. I definitely was going a little crazy compared to like how I practice when I stream. I'm usually all about the consistency and, you know, the balance with the crazy combos and crazy like edge guarding, but it's usually leaning towards like consistency. But I feel like at Momentous, I feel like it was like a fun meter. Like the more fun I had, I did something riskier and I was like, oh shit, like calm down. Yeah. It would like almost lose me a game. I think in grand finals versus Leon, and honestly in winter semis, sometimes I would get a bit ahead of myself. It's not the worst thing ever. Like, it's okay to do that occasionally. Sometimes it really pays off. And I think in grand finals, I think I would blame that a little bit. I think in terms of difficulty, I think a lot of what happened really at the end of it, like when it comes down to it, was a lot of the same stuff. Kind of like Diddy Kong just like outclassing Bowser in the head-to-head, it feels like. But yeah, Leon did do really well in grand finals too. And he also tried Banjo game one, which is a character that would definitely give Diddy Kong a hard time, and that match was pretty close, and it definitely like calmed me down, or like forced me to calm down, because I couldn't just like do crazy stuff like I would against Bowser. So yeah, other than that, I don't think it was like a world of a difference, but I do think Leon stepped it up, and I also think if I wanted to close out the set, I had to play a bit more consistent rather than taking crazy risks.
Okay, yeah, makes sense. I mean, that was your first tournament back, and obviously you are going to go to more offline events. So I guess, can you just list some of the tournaments that you're planning on going to, and I guess give your mindset approaching your upcoming events?
Riptide is probably the closest upcoming one that I can think of. There's Riptide, there's Low Tide City, there's CEO, there's Main Stage. I'm sure there's gonna be like smaller gaps of tournaments, but those are the ones at the moment. But I'll probably be traveling like a couple times a month, or like even more any day now as tournaments like kind of get announced. But yeah, those are the ones that come to mind. I'm glad you asked about the mindset when it comes to tournaments, because I feel like it's gonna be a lot different. I've always been the type of guy that doesn't look at my bracket, doesn't like play at the tournament. I kind of just like save all my energy for the bracket itself, and I kind of don't really care who I play.
But I guess I just want to like kind of put more emphasis on you not looking at your bracket. Sometimes you would get mad at people for telling you who you play in bracket. Yeah. Like you really did not want to know who you played at all.
Yeah, I was just convinced that I like would overthink it if I did know. Like whenever I talk to the people that have known me for a long time, they'd be like, yeah, whenever like you know who you're playing, you'll just start asking us like a bunch of questions like, oh, should I do this? Should I do this? Should I go this character? Should I go this character? And I kind of wanted to avoid that just because it was exhausting. I think nowadays, like, I've kind of got it out of my system. I feel like I've grown up a bit. I've like worked on a lot of, you know, mental side of competing and like the psychology of it. So I don't mind anymore. Like, I don't care either way. But from a gameplay standpoint, I also want to know more, because Diddy Kong is the core of my game plan. So if they play a really dangerous character for me, I want to know beforehand so I won't start Diddy, or I'm ready for it, or whatever it may be. So that's the thing. I feel like previously I played characters that were so well-rounded that I could worry about it after like game one or something. But nowadays, you know, it's a mix of gameplay and like outside factors that I kind of want to prepare a bit more for brackets now. You know, Smash GG definitely helps with that. Going to Momentous and taking part of the World Tour definitely helped me with how I'm going to approach it and how I'm going to prepare in the future, because those were like my first times really playing in a serious environment with Diddy. So that's definitely gonna be a lot different going into it.
Do you intend to practice your Sephiroth and Wolf more? Because I mean, you did say that Diddy Kong is by far your best character, and that's like the character you put more time time into, but you also said that there are matchups that you don't want to play with him. So do you want to like just make sure you're polished with Sephiroth and Wolf in those matchups, or do you think you're fine as is?
Yeah, I definitely, it may sound weird, but I actually am using Diddy Kong like 99-100% of the time, just because kind of like what I said, like I'm kind of trying to like learn more about those hard matchups, and if I can figure something out, that's like the best case scenario for me. So I definitely should be practicing more Sephiroth and Wolf than I am at the moment. Whenever I practice like offline, I definitely pull out Sephiroth more often. Even when I'm doing like Metafy lessons, for example, I'm just using Diddy Kong unless they want me to use some sort of character to help them. He's just the character I lean towards for fun and for practice. But yeah, I definitely should be practicing the Sephiroth more. When it comes to Wolf, I think he's a bit more low maintenance, and the way I play Wolf against some of these like characters like Pac-Man, it's all about like camping and fundamentals.
blaster.
I won't even sugarcoat it. Like, I'm the Wolf player that knows how to shoot the gun. So he's pretty low maintenance for the job he serves for me. I definitely could afford to practice him more too. I shouldn't be too lazy, because you never know when I might think I need him. But yeah, especially Sephiroth, because he's not as low maintenance as Wolf, I think. But the thing is, Diddy Kong is so high maintenance that I feel like I need to be playing him more than the other two, even if Diddy is my strongest. I don't know. My brain is pretty much wired to play Diddy Kong now, because there's so many specific things to him that I feel like if I take a couple days off, I need to unrust, which is really different experience for me, because I could usually just play any character anytime, but I'm so focused on Diddy now that I actually have a harder time playing other characters. And I know a lot of people know me as someone that plays a lot of characters, but it's not as natural for me anymore ever since I started taking Diddy Kong seriously. Once again, it feels like my brain is wired to play Diddy Kong and everything else is a bit harder.
Wow. that's actually really interesting to hear. Like, what's going to be your approach to balance that thing? Because it sounds like to me that you feel like, yes, you should be practicing more characters like Sephiroth and Wolf, but then you also feel like you need to be practicing Diddy Kong like way more. So like, how are you going to find time to balance that out?
Yeah, it's not that I feel like he'll get rusty. It's kind of going back to what I was saying, where like my brain is wired to play Diddy Kong ever since I started taking him serious. And I took him that serious because I knew that he had some weaknesses in his matchup chart. So if I was gonna make him the core part of my gameplay, I had to really work as hard on him as I possibly could to balance that out, right? I kind of viewed it as my quarantine gamble. That's what I call it, Diddy Kong. Putting him in the front lines of my lineup is definitely uncharacteristic of something I would do. I usually value the consistency, but I had enough faith that it was possible. Basically, I didn't want him to hold me back, so I put the extra time into it to make sure that doesn't happen.
Yeah.
I put so much time into doing that, I realized that I didn't want to play anyone else, and I also couldn't play anyone else as easily as I could before. So I'm kind of just stuck with him now. Just fine, it's what I want.
Yeah.
But it's actually really funny that it kind of like went in reverse. How like I was playing him so much to make sure he didn't hold me back, and now he's like my best option, like whether it should or shouldn't be. So it's definitely really funny. But yeah, I have enough faith in like solid, just like fundamental play. And I also just don't think Sephiroth or Wolf are as hard as Diddy. So I feel like the amount I'm playing Sephiroth isn't terrible, but maybe I should try to do it a little bit more. Maybe I should stop playing too much Pokemon and practice a little bit more.
No more shiny hunting?
I have over 900 hours in Sword and Shield.
Jeez. You talked about going to major events. Do you plan on going to any local events? Especially since, you know, the Tri-State area is the best region in the US. You know, offline locals open back up. I don't know how close you are to any of them, but there are some open in the Tri-State area. So do you plan on going to any?
I definitely do. I think the hardest thing is I have to find the balance with Metafy and streaming and YouTube, because I wasn't doing that before. I don't think it's going to be too hard to figure out. My schedule is usually pretty flexible, so I do plan on going locals at some point in the future. I was going to a bunch of locals before quarantine. Competing is always my number one priority, so locals are great practice. I haven't gone into any yet, but I definitely will be going to them. They're not like crazy far, they're not like crazy close either, so it's definitely worth it. And like you said, it's good practice in this region. But yeah, I've been going to locals the entirety of me competing in Smash, so I'll definitely get back to it at some point.
Okay, so next DLC character, Kazuya. We're gonna have a presentation on Monday. What's your opinion on Kazuya? Did you like him? Did you hate him?
How about I ask you, how do you think I reacted to Kazuya and Smash?
Oh, you were pissed.
Oh yeah, I was super fucking pissed. Yeah.
I mean, I know, but for the sake of interviewing you, you know, I have to ask.
Yeah. So I was watching it with B and Charles on her stream, and I just couldn't contain the anger. I couldn't fake the reaction. Like, I wanted to just not say anything. And the first thing I said was, God fucking damn it. Like, I was just like looking down. Like, I was like acting like it's the end of the world. I did not expect a fighting game character. Like, I was ready to like be disappointed, but I wasn't ready to be angry.
Okay, question. Was it worse than the Steve reaction? Because that was one of the funniest live reactions I've ever seen. That was so funny because like B was like so happy and you just looked like someone just killed your puppy or something.
Yeah, it's hard to compare them because it's like different. With Steve, it was like, as a Smash fan, it just felt like I just didn't think it was possible. I didn't think it was gonna happen. I thought it was a little cringe. A lot cringe, not a little cringe. I know that Steve deserves it, and like I get that. Like, statistically, Minecraft deserves to be in every video game ever. Like, it's like the greatest video game ever in terms of sales. But like, as a fan of Smash, like, I couldn't help it. But that was just like shocked, like disappointment. But with Kazuya, it was like pure rage. Like, because I know what it is, right? Like, I just fucking hate Ken, Ryu, and Terry a lot. And I also have a hard time containing my anger for them. Usually I like try to like stay calm and just play against anything. But dude, sometimes playing against Terry, I just can't help but verbally say out loud, like, what is this? Like, what am I playing against? But thankfully, I have Diddy Kong, and it bounces out because I feel like Diddy Kong does really well versus those types of characters. So despite my personal issues with the characters, it definitely helps that Diddy Kong does so well. Just throw a banana at them and you'll be all right. I was really upset, and it kind of ruined all of E3 for me. Like, I'm overreacting, but I just couldn't help it. I did not expect it. I was like, yeah, this E3 sucked. Like, Nintendo didn't do anything. And then like a week later, I was like, it was actually pretty good.
Metroid Dread?
That was like, I was excited for that even in the moment. Everything else, like, I didn't care that much. I wish they ended it with Kazuya. E3 wouldn't have been ruined for me, but I was so mad. Yeah, I hope that character sucks.
I'm gonna be honest. I don't think he's gonna suck.
I know he's not gonna suck, but there's the smallest chance that he does.
Do you like know much about Tekken?
No.
Dude, they have like 100 moves.
I know he's gonna have the most moves. Okay, so here's the reason why there's a 1% chance he's trash, because of the Tekken frame data. That's the only possibility, because it's gonna be a little slower than like Ken and Ryu, but he also has so much stuff that it probably doesn't matter. I don't know. I know Diddy Kong will do great. That's all I know. And if he doesn't, then I'm out of here. I'm going back to shiny hunting. I quit.
Oh, all right. So you're going to be the TSM FTX Pokemon player.
Yeah. Not even like competitive, just shiny hunter.
The shiny hunter.
I just hope the last character, like, no more fighting game characters, please.
How would you feel if the last character was a Pokemon? Because I feel like there's a very good chance it's a Pokemon.
You would expect me to be like super hyped because Pokemon's like my favorite. But honestly, most Pokemon in Smash aren't that fun for me. I don't like Pikachu or Pichu or Greninja. PT's really fun. Incineroar's really fun. Lucario's okay. Mewtwo is pretty fun. I guess it's pretty good overall. I just think if they do add a Pokemon, it's not going to be anything too new to the table. Because most of the Pokemon, I feel like design-wise, are pretty tame. They don't go above and beyond like they did with PT or something. If it's something like that, then it's gonna be the opposite of the Steve reaction. It's gonna be very exciting, but I just feel like if they do a Pokemon, it might be pretty tame. I really want Porky from Mother.
Yeah.
I really want Dante, and my stupid pick is I want Conker.
And Conker would be hype. All right, Tweak, hear me out. What if the last character is a Pokemon, but it's Rillaboom, and he plays like a better DK?
Sign me up. The lifestyle is back in business.
Exactly.
Because with Diddy, I'm just playing a little baby DK. Like, the back air, like, reminds me of my past. you know, just, you know, the double kicks.
Yeah.
But obviously it's not the lifestyle. I definitely need a DLC heavyweight, but I don't know if it's going to happen.
Yeah, only time will tell.
No more fighting game characters. They're too stressful to fight. You know how it feels to fight them. It's terrifying.
Yeah. I'm actually a fan of Tekken, so I actually might legit, like, try Kazuya.
Don't ask me for friendlies. Don't talk to me or look at me. Just say the stages you strike in band, say the character you're going, and I'll do the same. And only fist bumps, no handshakes.
Like, no eye contact at all, I just look straight forward.
Yep.
After the match, just put my hand out like this, it's fist bumps.
Yes, there you go. You know what to do.
I guess on that note, I'll end it here. Yeah, dude, thanks for coming on again. Appreciate it. I hope I see you soon at one of these tournaments, man. Appreciate it.
Yeah, I can't wait.
Yeah.